Today I'm going to be talking about an artifact from the past that was quite popular in the late 80s into the early 90s. I certainly owned a few. I'm talking about cassette singles, or cassingles as they were nicknamed. Now before we go any further, I just want to remind you to please subscribe to my channel. It won't cost you anything, there is no obligation expected of you, but it will certainly help my channel grow. So please click on that subscribe button in the bottom right corner. I post new tech reviews every week, and the best way to stay on top of all the latest reviews is to subscribe. It would be greatly appreciated. Thank you so much. Now, these cassette singles often came in a cardboard sleeve and usually had no more than two songs on them, although I do recall some that had three or four songs on them. And usually it would be a hit single by a particular band or artist, plus another song from the album. Or sometimes there would be various mixes of the song, or even a live track. And usually you would have two songs on one side and the same two songs on the other side as well. And back in the day, I recall they usually sold for somewhere between $3 to $4. Now, from my experience, I would say that the golden age of cassette singles was somewhere between 1989 to 1991. However, they actually had been around for long before that. The first cassette single was released in the UK in 1980 by EMI, and this was the song C30, C60, C90 Go by Bow Wow Wow. And the first cassette single released in the US was Vacation by the Go-Go's in 1982. Now, American record companies really began pushing cassette singles in 1987 when vinyl sales were really starting to drop. The cassette single was intended to be a replacement of the 7-inch 45 RPM single. Now, in some areas, cassette singles were sold in standard plastic jewel cases with a J card. Now, eventually, companies began to release maxi singles, which sometimes included 5 or 6 tracks and could include dance mixes, radio edits, a cappella or instrumental versions of the song. Cassette singles were phased out by the mid-2000s. I certainly don't recall seeing that many of them around after the mid to late 90s. And some say that the cassette single died out because many music fans viewed it as a wasteful use of media. For example, it only had a few tracks on it, but it took up the same amount of space as a regular cassette. Some of the cassette singles that I owned way back in the day included songs by Michael Penn, Sinead O'Connor, Jive Bunny and the Master Mixers, High Tech 3, Living Color, and so on. I will mention also that the cassette single did make a little bit of a comeback. Lady Gaga released some of her songs on cassette single, namely Stupid Love and Rain On Me. She released both of those tracks on cassette single in 2020, so they did have a very slight comeback. But overall, the cassette single is certainly a relic of the past. You can find them on various websites like eBay. I do see that they usually sell anywhere from $5 to $10 each, sometimes less, sometimes more. And they're certainly a very fun artifact from the past. Thank you for watching. I hope you can join us again next time. Please give us a thumbs up, leave a comment. We'd love to hear from you. And as always, please feel free to subscribe. Thanks again. We'll see you again next time. Take care. Bye-bye.